times are strange. Here I come, but I ain't the same.
Hey, how y'all doing? Welcome back to another episode of Cooper Outdoors. My name's Matt Cooper. Today I'm up here with a few friends of mine, and we decided we was gonna come up here and do a little video on some squirrel hunting, and I believe y'all gonna like it. Y'all sit back, and we'll be back with you here in just a minute.
This right here would be fun to walk a horse through.
Yeah.
It's just amazing. Put the kick in the eye.
About the only thing you get his nose through, he's good and young.
We'll come back, there'll be a big snake eating him.
We found a bunch of these acorns laying on the ground. Looks like they got plenty to eat around here. They've been cutting on them a little bit. Plenty of them littered across the floor, so they got plenty to eat in this area. So there's definitely plenty of squirrels in here.
These here are acorn cuttings. These squirrels are up above us and cutting on these little young acorns.
This is the first one of the season. Just got him just a few minutes ago. Looks like we're going to have a pretty productive day. Hopefully we can bag a few more of these and make us a good mess.
Alright, well, we saved the gruesome part for later videos. We'll show some how-tos on that. We got this squirrel skinned out here. Just a quick skinning. Took the fur off of him, took all the useless parts off. Got the stick bark of it all scraped off. You want to be sure to use green type wood, but not real sappy. You don't want the wood to burn into while you're cooking, so that's why you want to use green wood. Which is basically what we're going to do is run his hindquarters right up to the end of this stick here. Basically put him on here like a big shish kebab. Run him down this stick, depending on how big your stick is and everything, depending on where you're going to put him. Stretch him on there like that, get him ready for the far, which we got going right now. We got it building up, building a good size far for this. We'll be able to turn him and cook him right slower. That's a good little meal here in a few minutes. Stick with. Alright, we got our seasoning mixed up here. Done took a little combination of some different spices. Kind of made my own up here. Got some of that booyah in there. Give it a little kick. I throwed some seasoning salts in there. And then a little secret ingredient I like adding into some things. People usually don't even notice it until they talk about how good it is, and when I tell them, they don't believe it. But, got this seasoning here all ready to go. Got it all mixed up. I'm ready to go. I'm gonna put it on the, rub it on. Sprinkle it on right good. We just got done washing this off, so it'll be good and moist, so it'll, seasoning will stick on it good. Make sure you have plenty of seasoning, you know, you don't be shy with it. Squirrel's a pretty wild, gamey tasting meat anyway. So we're going to soak it down here right good and see what we can come up with. I finish this up, y'all be sure to stay tuned. We'll show you how we're going to cook it over the fire. All right, what we've done here is we took some forked sticks, got them about the right height, and shoved them down in the ground on both sides of the fire. Got us a good heat fire. I know you don't see a lot of flame off of that, but it's real hot. We're going to take this stick, we're going to set it on here. What we're talking about doing here is indirect heat. We don't want to cook him right over top of the flames because that'll cause him to charbroil and to burn. We want to cook him off of just the heat coming off the fire, not necessarily the flame. And like I said, you can't really tell it, but this is a very hot fire. I mean, it's really hot right here. So that far of a distance, we'll move him in a little closer as we see what's going on with him as we're cooking him. We'll get back with you the finished product here in just a minute.